Hello, this is Matt Worley, and this video will cover the Lucidi 2.0 for iPad and iPhone, and we'll look at configuration and logging in. So to begin this process, the first thing you want to do on your iPad device is to go to the App Store, which typically is an icon that looks like this on your tablet, and once you're in the App Store, if you do a search for Lucidi, and when the search results come up, you're going to see several things perhaps pop up, but the one you want to look for is Lucidi 2.0. That's the one that we're using here, and it's the application that works with Lucidi 2016 and higher for server versions. So if you go ahead and tap the cloud and the down arrow to download that application, it will download it and install it on your device. It normally just takes a few seconds, as you can see there. And then once you are back out on your device, you'll notice that the Lucidi icon has shown up here just like it does for all other apps on an iPad. When you first tap on that to open it, it will ask for some permissions. And you may get permissions prompts for various things like location and those kinds of things, but eventually you'll get to this screen that looks like it's just a blank screen, but it says clients at the top, and you'll want to tap this plus button up here in the corner to add a new client. Now there are several fields here that you need to fill out. One is the name and the host, and the very last one down here at the bottom is the REST path. And these things are all determined by how your mobile server is set up. So this video assumes that your mobile server is already installed, and we're just trying to set up the tablet to connect to it. So for this one, I'll just leave this as production. It's the way that it came in as defaulted, and that seems fine for me, but you might want to change the name to something that's more in line with whatever you need it to say, however descriptive you need that to say it. And then the other three settings, the host and the REST path at the bottom, come from the settings for your mobile server. So to find those, you'll go into your web application. So this is the web application for the same environment we're going to connect to. And if you go to the admin portal, once you have the admin portal open, if you go over here to settings and expand that and go to system settings, and in this drop down here, there's a variety of things you can filter on, but if you filter for specifically the mobile settings, you'll come to this screen. And the very last setting here is the URL for the Lucidi mobile server directory. And so in my demo environment here, what this has is HTTPS and then demo.lucidi.net and then Lucidi mobile server. So the first part of this is the scheme. The second part of this, the demo.lucidi.net, is the host. And the third is Lucidi mobile server. Depending on how yours was installed, this host will likely be different, but the rest of it may be a little different too. So iOS is going to require a scheme of HTTPS, so we don't have to enter that information because it assumes that that's how you have your mobile server set up. But we will need to enter the host and the REST path, and so we can go back to our app to do that. So here in the host field, I'm going to put what I found in that setting in my web app, demo.lucidi.net. And then if I scroll down to where it says the REST path, it already has Lucidi mobile server, so it defaults that way. So you may not have to change that at all. So it may be that you'll just need to enter the host. I also recommend you probably ought to enable full logging here because it will help us log issues in case you have trouble getting connected the first time. Once you're done with this, if you just tap done, then back at the client list, you're going to have that client listed here. You may have several here. Most of you, may only have one or two, but you can then tap on the client that you want to select. In this case, I'm going to tap on production. And when I do that, it's going to take me to a credential screen where I can enter my credentials. So these are the same credentials for the user that you would use in the web application. And once you have entered those and tapped login, then it will actually take you to the dashboard. We will cover the dashboard in a different video, but there, once you're logged in, there are a couple of other settings you might want to adjust on your tablet, and these are per user. So if you go up here in the upper right hand corner to this box with the arrow, this is a menu, and if you tap on that, it's going to give you a lot of options, but one of those is settings. So this settings dialog, when you open it, it's going to give you a variety of things that you've already seen, but then down here in the bottom, there are some other things that you might want to look at. So one of those is page size. Page size is how many records are loaded into a particular grid when you load a grid like from work orders. And it defaults to 15. If that's okay with you, then you can just leave it. But you could change it to 10 or to 20 or to 25. And then there are some settings down here at the bottom for the map, which we will talk about in some videos that I'll create about the map. The very last one of these is an alternate view setting, and again, that's something that will be shown in a different video. So once you've gotten those settings the way you want them, then you're ready to use the application. And the dashboard and the views and the forms and the map will be covered, the functionality for those will be covered in separate videos.